My name is Amara Chibonyedilefu. I'm from Ezialahomara, Ezinitemse local government area of Imo State. I'm 25 years old. I'm a student, a blind student of University of Nigeria Nsukka, studying public administration. My eye problem started when I was 2 years old. It just one day, one of my eyes, the left one to be precise, started changing color from the normal color to something like blue. So my parents took me to the hospital. The doctor said that it was a pressure in the eye and he had to carry out a surgery. So the surgery was carried out. After that, the eye got damaged. I was only using the right one to see. Then after some years, like 3 years later, the left one started affecting the other one. From there, I went for another surgery and it wasn't successful too. That was why I lost my sight completely. Ever since then, I can't see again with the eyes. Being a student, a blind student in the university, is not an easy one. I live in the general hostel with others, the other sighted students. It's not really easy being a blind student among the sighted ones. I find it difficult going to the classes and looking for someone to help me go to the class. Because the classes are not really close to the hostels. Then the academic challenges, like getting someone to read notes, because all our textbooks are not brailled. They are not in braille, it's in the printed materials. So I look for someone to read for me, because why I don't have any braille is that I lack the braille machine or the braille embosser which can get my textbooks into braille materials. So this makes it very difficult for me to get someone to read for me. Then another thing is that some of the things we use, like the recorders, braille machines, braille papers, they are not produced here in Nigeria. They are gotten from overseas. So, and they are very costly. Sometimes I don't afford, I can't buy them because of the cost. So these are very, very difficult. Studies. If I can be provided with my equipment, like my reading materials, such as the braille machine, laptops, recorders, braille papers, all these things will help me to study very hard, well, and do well in my academics. Then after my school, I want to work in French embassy. That is my dream. And I would also like to kind of establish a braille printing house that can help to uplift my fellow blind students who will be coming up, who are in the university, and who will also the younger ones that are coming up, And this to establish this thing, I need something like embosser. It's a braille printer. Then another thing is that I like to be a musician, because I have already composed some songs, but I've not watched them. these are my dreams, what I like to achieve in the future. My advice to people in similar condition, whether blind, those who cannot walk, those who cannot see, those who have hearing impairments, those who have one disability or the other, my advice to them is that they should kind of be strong, be happy, and try to work hard. It's not that you have a disability, you go and sit down, fold your arms, you don't want to go to school, you don't want to help yourself, you always be there thinking, crying, making things difficult for yourself. The best thing to do is just to, arise and shine. Don't allow the impediment you have to be a kind of hindrance to what God has planned for you in this life. Because, according to my name says Onyedilefu. This means that, God has a plan for everybody. God created everybody for a purpose, and which He will help you to achieve it. In helping you is that you will first of all help yourself, because heaven helps those who help themselves. Once you rise on your feet and say, no, I can't allow this challenge to weigh me down, I must achieve what others are achieving. If you have a mindset that since you are alive, there is hope. Since there is life, there is hope. You can do what others are doing. Don't go inside and keep yourself inward. Keep blaming God for creating you. God has a reason for bringing you to this life. You have a challenge, does not mean that it's the end of your life. You can still make it in any situation you find yourself. The first thing is determination. When you are determined to do something, you must make it. So that's what I can say to them.